हेलो डियर किड्स, वेलकम टू आवर कंप्यूटर क्लास। आई एम योर रिंकल मिस एंड आई विल टीच यू कंप्यूटर टुडे। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 1, द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम। लेट्स स्टार्ट। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ आईपीओ साइकिल। हियर आई फॉर इनपुट, पी फॉर प्रोसेस एंड ओ फॉर आउटपुट। First, we can give input either data and instructions using keyboard. Then after, on the data and instructions, CPU will process. Then after, CPU will generate result. And that result we can see on the monitor screen. And that result is called output. So, on this IPO cycle, computer system is working. Now, next topic is input devices. The devices that are used to give input to the computer are called input devices. We can attach input devices to the computer. Here, keyboard, mouse, joystick, touchpad, scanner, web camera, these all are input devices. Using these devices, we can give input to the computer. Let's first see keyboard. Using keyboard, we can type anything on the computer. Most keyboards have 101 keys. A keyboard has some types of keys like alphabet keys from A to Z, keys with symbol like greater than, less than, equals to, at the rate, etc. Function keys from F1 to F12 and some other special keys like space bar, enter key, shift key, etc. Next is mouse. Using mouse, we can select and point the things on the monitor. Mouse also helps us to do clicking, scrolling, double clicking, drag and drop, and right click on the monitor screen. Most mouse has two buttons, left button and right button. Next is joystick. Joystick is mostly used to play games and it has a long handle mounted on a platform at the bottom side. Joystick has buttons to perform different actions during the game. Next is touchpad. Touchpad is a rectangular shaped device found in laptops. It is a one type of mouse for laptops. Touchpad mostly has left and right buttons. Next is stylus and graphics tablet. It is look like a pen. It is used to write or tap on the monitor screen or a mobile screen. It is mostly used to draw on the computer. Next is scanner. Scanner is used to get documents and images on paper into the computer. Scanner scans the text or images and saves it into the computer. So anything we have on paper, we can take it into the computer using scanner. Next is web camera. In short, we can say that webcam. Web camera is used by the computer to capture images. Web camera is mostly used in video calls. Images can be saved in the picture also. And web camera is also used for video calls using the computer. Now, next is output devices. The devices used by the computer for output are called output devices. Monitor is the most common output device because computer provides us output using monitor screen. First is monitor. Here two types of monitors, monitor of computer and monitor of a laptop. Monitor is look like a television and that displays what we do on the computer. Whatever we are doing on a computer is displayed on the monitor. So everything computer shows us using its monitor screen. Next output device is speakers. Using speaker, we can listen music, video and voice recordings on the computer. Which device would you use if you want to other people to get disturbed by the music you are listening to? Yes, it's headphones. Using headphones, you can listen music without disturbing other people. Next is printer. Printer is used to get output on paper. And output on paper is called hard copy or printout. Anything from the computer we can take out of the computer and we can take print using printer. Now there are four types of printers: dot matrix printer, inkjet printer, laser printer and plotter. Now, next is processing device. Here, processing device is CPU, which full form is Central Processing Unit. It processes the data and provides us output. That's why it is called processing device. It is the brain of a computer. And CPU has three parts, ALU, CU and registers. Now, hardware. The parts of computer that we can touch and feel are called hardware. For example, keyboard, mouse and printer. These devices are called hardware. We can touch that parts and we can feel that parts. Next is software. Software is something that we cannot touch and feel. It is totally opposite to the hardware. We cannot touch the software. For example, Paint, WordPad and Notepad. In short, we can say that software is application or program installed in the computer that we cannot touch, but we can work on them. Here two types of software are there, system software and application software. System software helps us to use various hardware devices is system software. But application software is helps us to perform a particular task on a computer. And the example of system software is device drivers and the example of application software is Paint, which is helps us to draw and color. WordPad, which is helps us to do typing and create letters. So here student, our chapter first is over. Thank you.